गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल. टुडे आई विल टॉक अबाउट एम्ब्लोपिया और लेजी आई. लेजी आई डेवलप्स व्हेन द चाइल्ड डज नॉट गेट करेक्ट विजुअल स्टिमुलेशन इन द वीकर आई. सो इफ वन आई इज वीकर देन द अदर, दैट आई इज द वीकर आईज इमेजेस नॉट टेकन बाय द ब्रेन एंड दस द आई बिकम्स सप्रेस्ड एंड लेटर ऑन इट डेवलप्स एम्ब्लोपिया. So amblyopia affects around 2% of population. It is quite alarming. So critical period is from birth to 7 to 8 years, okay, and it's the most common cause of childhood blindness. We need to be very very alert. So strabismus causes 50% of amblyopia cases. It is very alarming. So due to squint, amblyopia develops. Refractive error causes 15 to 20% of amblyopia. So if the child is having high refractive error in both eyes and it's uncorrected, the parent does not take the child to the doctor, and so what happens, the eye is not corrected optically, and so the child's eye seeing those blurred images and the brain is accustomed to take those blurred images only. So never, when after suppose 10 years of age when we are correcting the child, we cannot get the 100% vision. So this is called a bilateral amblyopia due to high refractive error in both eyes. Also, if the child is having anisometropia, means one eye there is a very high refractive error, other eye is almost zero or something. Suppose the child is having zero refractive error in right eye, left eye is having -7. So -7 refractive error eye, the child will not see anything, almost very blurred images. So the brain will suppress that high refractive error eye, and slowly it will be amblyopic. So this is anisometropia. Also, the due to visual deprivation, stimulus deprivation, amblyopia occurs. That is also less than 5%. The child is having a congenital cataract, ptosis, or a corneal scar. So visual stimulus is not reaching the weaker eye, and that's the reason the child is having a amblyopia. So coming to the types of amblyopia, strabismic amblyopia, what we are discussing. So this eye is, child is having squint in this eye. So what is happening, this eye is crossed, and so that's the reason the other eye is straight. So that's the reason there is double vision. So, and this eye is weaker also, the squint eye is weaker, so the brain does not take the weaker eye's image to avoid double vision or diplopia. That's how it develops into suppression and amblyopia in later stages. So this is a convergent squint, this is a divergent squint, okay. So it needs to be treated at the earliest. Refractive amblyopia, what we have discussed, we need to give optimal correction. We need to correct both the eyes. Refractive error should be corrected properly, otherwise it can develop amblyopia. Anisometropia can be best corrected with contact lenses in the high refractive error eye. Stimulus deprivation amblyopia, what we have discussed, and unilateral cataract you can see here. Okay, so this eye, if not gets operated, this eye will get deprived of the visual stimulus and it can develop into amblyopia later stages. So we need to operate the congenital cataract at the earliest. This is a ptosis case. Ptosis means drooping of the upper lid. Left eye is having that. So that's the reason what is happening. There is deprivation of visual stimulus. So that eye may become amblyopic if not operated earliest. So the treatment approach should be as early as possible. We should initiate the treatment as early as possible. We need to go with the conservative treatment first or a non-surgical treatment first, and then other things. We can give glasses, contact lens. We can patch the better seeing eye or the good eye, and then make the patient work, make the child work with the amblyopic eye. We give some task and make the child work with the amblyopic eye. If the child does not wants to wear any patch, we can do an atropine penalization. Okay, atropine eye drop is used by the with the many, if the clinician suggests that. So we can do that. We can give a frosted glass also in the good eye and make the amblyopic eye work. Also, we can do a amblyopia vision therapy. Let's look into that. So here in this figure, you can see the child is drawing with the help of a thyroscope. So thyroscope basically has a septum and makes use of both the eyes. Okay, so if the child is not using his amblyopic eye or the lazy eye, so weaker eye, so he will not be able to trace or draw the image. Okay, second one you can see, this is called a red green bar reader. So red green bar reader, you need to use it over a book, and the child, you put a red green goggles. Okay, with the help of red green goggles and red green bar reader, he has to utilize both his eyes to read those, read the book. So if the child cannot read, put the child more effort to read. Okay, this one is a CAM stimulator. You can see here there are some gratings and all that will rotate in that instrument. You can control the speed and the child see through the amblyopic eye. So it will create a visual stimulus to the amblyopic eye. Fourth one is very important. This is amblyopia vision therapy. You can hear the child wear a red green goggles or a polarized glasses. Okay, and he is given some video games, some computerized vision software based on dioptric stimulation if he is using that red green goggles. Okay, so these amblyopia vision therapy, with the help of amblyopia this vision therapy software, actually works best. Okay, so we need to patch the eye for 2-3 hours a day. Okay, and let the child do some homework and other tasks, and bring the child to the consultant optometrist and go for an amblyopia vision therapy. So if the child does it properly, then it can actually cure amblyopia. Okay, so also another thing, let me tell, amblyopia can revert back. So to stop reverting back, what we can give, we can give some home vision therapy exercises to the child, so the child practices at home, and so it can prevent the recurrence of amblyopia. If the child is having squint, we need to have a strabismic surgery, strabismus surgery we need to do, and if there is a congenital cataract or ptosis, we need to have surgical intervention. Treatment must be continued until best vision is reached, because 25% patient can have recurrence after 1 year, so if they stop the vision therapy. Okay, so best results are obtained around 5 to 8 years of age. So amblyopia must be treated at this age to stop recurrence of amblyopia. So these are the treatment goals of amblyopia. If amblyopia is diagnosed at a proper time, lazy eye is diagnosed at a proper time, do follow these instructions. Do consult an optometrist or a pediatric consultant. Get your child's eye treated. That is very important, because it can prevent lazy eye in the future. So lazy eye is nothing but the eye becomes non-functional. That is the thing. Thank you all.